a lot of people know I've been a North fan since I was a kid, and I used to love watching the fight from the fight he had with Trinidad and other fights after that, the first fight with Roy Jones. So I've always loved boxing growing up. But a lot of people thought his style of fighting used to be boring, but it never was boring to me. I just thought I was just seeing somebody that just knew how to win. He was real crafty. So I used to, people say, Bernard's boring. Why you watch Bernard? Why you don't watch Roy Jones? Well, I did watch Roy Jones, but I just learned more from Bernard. I just thought Roy Jones relied on a lot of athletics instead of boxing IQ. But Bernard inspired me because of his life, everything that he went through as far as going to prison, losing his brother. And so, and boxing was a way out for him. And I kind of went down the same path that he went down. And so that was kind of my way out as well.
Awesome, man. What did you learn from those experiences of being incarcerated? How did that make you a better person? How did it get you to where you are today?
Well, I was in a 24-hour lockup, so in there, all you have is time to think. And so I was thinking, what can I do to ensure that I never come back to this place again? What can I ensure to make my parents proud of me, because I had put them through so much? And then I had a son that was at the time that I was missing his first steps, his first words, crawling, I was missing everything. So I was like, what can I do when I get out of here that he can have somebody to look up to, that he can be, say, my daddy doing this, my daddy. So somebody he can be proud of. So that was all, then reading books. It all played a part. Everything played a part.
Awesome, man. How did you get here? Like, how did you get to this point, just in life, where you are now, boxing on prime time, what would have been a pay-per-view card, you know, just the life journey. How did you get here?
Faith. Because I've been through a lot. Inside the ring and outside the ring from the age of 13 up to, I can remember, I've been through.
Rephrase it, I was saying, this is how I got here, because remember, I'm no questions from me, so everything is going to be from you. So just, you know, I got here through, or one of the things that helped me get here are.
I got here through my faith in God, because all the stuff that I've been through in life, inside and outside of the ring, I just always stayed positive. Nothing ever broke me. I mean, I've been close to being broke, and let's take that back, I've been shattered, but I was able to piece myself back together bit by bit. The support of family, friends, and through this sport of boxing, because without this sport, I don't know where I'd be.
Awesome, man. Who do you fight for now?
I fight for myself. I fight for my son. I fight for my family. I fight for my legacy. I fight for everybody who's been to prison that when they get out, they don't understand. They don't believe that they have a second chance, or they believe statistics. I didn't become a statistic. I defied all odds. And so I fight for kids who just growing up in poverty, who don't know which way to go, and who need somebody to look up to, a big brother or a role model who can just lay eyes on and say, if he can do it, I can do it. And so, because I've been in their shoes, and so that's what I do it for.
Awesome, man. Seeing how Clay Collard is blowing up this summer, you know, you have a win over Clay Collard. So does knowing you have a win over Clay Collard and seeing his success kind of inspire you or give you even more hope of what you can accomplish with your boxing career?
Yeah, I mean, I'm extremely proud of Clay Collard, because he's done a lot. Like, he's taken the B side on several fights and wasn't expected to win, and he came in and he did what he had to do. When I fought Clay, he was my toughest fight thus far, because as you can see, he's a dog, he's a warrior, so he was my toughest fight thus far. But it does give me motivation. Like, if he can do it and I beat him, then I can do it. So it keeps me hungry, it keeps me humble, but it keeps me firing on all cylinders.
Awesome, man. What do you learn from just being around a championship team of guys in Houston, like, you know, Charlo brothers, being around Regis, having Coach K and some of the people in your corner, you know, how have those guys kind of helped you get to where you are?
Everybody's played a good role in where I'm at thus far, especially K. Garoma, because he was on my team. He was been in my corner since the USA team. And so we built a real good relationship to a real life family. So he never shies away from inviting me to camp. Dealing with the Charlo brothers, I understand more how the business go of it. And because when I fought on their card at Vegas last year at the Mandalay Bay on the Coda undercard, I got a chance to see how they do it on a grand scale, on a bigger level. So fighting with the Charlos, I learned a lot. Working with Regis has always been a good dude to me. So I spar him. I spar Regis more than I spar any of them. And so, and they all just humble. They all just keep me hungry. When I see them doing good and I'm in the ring with them, I can never slip when I'm in the ring with somebody that's as good as them. So they make me better every time I'm in the ring with them.
That's awesome, man. about, I know you lost your son. Is that one of the things that kind of helps drive you throughout your career, some of the different things as far as just inspiration things that you're fighting for?
Yes. As a parent, you never really prepare for something like that. Like, you never even think about burying your child. So when it happened to me, the whole world turned upside down. It was happened to me 30 days after I just won my national title. So I had been working at this one particular goal to become number one in the nation for a long time. My first day out of prison, when I went to the gym, I told my coach I'm gonna be number one in the nation. This was 2011. I trained for 2 years, finally started competing, finally won my national title in December 10th, 2016. January 10th, 2017, my son's gone. And so at that point, I was doing everything for him. I just needed him to know that your dad's not dead, not a bad person. He made a mistake. I made up for lost time, even though I couldn't get back in 2 years that I was away from him. I made up for lost time. Like, I did a lot. We had an extremely close bond, so he was always my motivation. And so since he was gone, it was, instead of fighting for him, I had to fight through him. So that's my motivation. I'm self-motivated as well, because I don't like to get beat up on. And I love this sport. I'm competitive at everything that I do. And so I'm just competitive. And so I'm self-motivated. I don't need nobody to tell me to do anything. I need somebody to tell me to stop, to rest. So my son's my motivation. I'm self-motivated. Having my parents tell me they're proud of me, because the kid I was and to the man I am now, that makes me feel good.
Awesome, man. Great story. Thank you for your time, brother. I wanted to sit down in there with them and have them talk to you and then catch you and see what I caught. But, I mean, some incredible stuff. I know they're going to do a great piece with you, man. Right, so thank you very much for your time.